Cindy Song. Yeon Jong Cindy Song was a 21-year-old South Korean student attending Pennsylvania State University. In 2001, she dressed up in a bunny costume and attended a Halloween party at a nightclub in State College. After leaving the club, Cindy spent the next few hours hanging out with her friends before she was dropped off at her apartment at approximately 4 a.m. This was the last anyone ever saw of her. After Sydney was reported missing, a search was conducted of her apartment. There was no sign of any struggle, but many of her belongings, including the false eyelashes from her costume, were there, indicating that she had gone inside after being dropped off. But what happened to her afterwards? Shortly thereafter, a witness reported seeing a lady resembling Sydney in the Chinatown district of Philadelphia. This lady was inside a vehicle with an unidentified male and crying out for help. A bizarre lead came about in 2003 when a Luzerne County man named Hugo Marcus Solansky was arrested after the remains of five people were found buried in his backyard. Even though none of these remains belonged to Sydney, an informant told police that Solansky and an accomplice named Michael Jason Krakowski Jr. had abducted her. After Sydney was raped and murdered, the two men allegedly buried her body at another location. Krakowski Jr. remains were found in Solansky's backyard, and the informant claimed Krakowski was murdered for keeping Sydney's bunny ears as a souvenir. Thus far, no evidence was found to tie Solansky to Cindy's disappearance, but in January of 2014, the burnt remains of a dozen more people were found buried on his property. Haim Weiss. Haim Weiss was a 15-year-old Orthodox Jewish boy attending the Mesvita of Long Beach, Yeshiva High School in New York. The morning after Halloween in 1986, the entire school was horrified when Haim was found murdered on his dorm room floor. He had been bludgeoned to death after a sharp blow to the skull and was repeatedly stabbed in the head, but no murder weapon could be found anywhere. Since there was no evidence of a struggle, it seemed likely that Haim was killed in his bed while he slept before his body was moved to the floor. By all accounts, Haim was a very well-liked boy, so no one could figure out a possible motive for the crime. There were signs that the killer was familiar with the religious customs of Orthodox Judaism. Even though it had been a chilly night, the window in Haim's room was open, a custom which is often done to let the deceased person's spirit out. After the murder, one of the school's rabbis left a memorial candle to burn in Haim's room. 2 days later, a second candle appeared, but no one ever admitted to putting it there. There were no signs of forced entry anywhere, indicating that the killer may have been familiar with the dormitory. During the night, another student in Haim's floor remembered being momentarily awakened when the door to his room was opened before it was immediately shut again. Could the killer have initially entered the wrong room by mistake? After 31 years, authorities have never been able to find a suspect or any answers about why Haim Weiss was murdered in such a brutal fashion. Orange socks. On Halloween of 1979, the unidentified body of a young lady was found in a concrete culvert near Interstate 35, just outside of Georgetown, Texas. The victim appeared to be in her 20s and had been sexually assaulted before she was strangled to death. It seemed likely she was murdered that very same day, and the only unique clue to her identity was a silver oval-shaped ring on her hand. The victim was fully nude, and the only garment of clothing she had on was a pair of orange socks. Since the young lady was never identified, Orange Socks became her nickname. Years later, serial killer Henry Lee Lucas confessed to the murder of Orange Socks. He even stated that he had sex with her corpse after she was dead. However, Lucas did not know the lady's identity. He claimed that he picked her up while hitchhiking and only remembered that her name was Joanie, or Judy. After being sentenced to death for the lady's murder in 1984, Lucas recanted his confession in order to have his sentence commuted. Indeed, further investigation showed that Lucas was likely working in Florida on the day of the murder. Lucas was notorious for frequently confessing to murders he never committed, and no one is sure how many people he actually killed. Henry Lee Lucas died in prison in 2001, but Orange Sox is not the only unidentified murder victim that he has been connected to. Chris Jenkins. Chris Jenkins was a 21-year-old student from the University of Minnesota who visited a downtown Minneapolis bar on Halloween night in 2002. After leaving the bar around midnight, Chris vanished without a trace. He remained a missing person for over 4 months until his body was discovered in the Mississippi River. Since Chris was still wearing his Halloween costume, all indications were that he died shortly after he disappeared. Chris was heavily intoxicated that night, and since his cause of death was determined to be drowning, authorities initially believed it was an accident or suicide. His parents, however, refused to believe this and pressed for more thorough investigation. Finally, in 2006, the death was reclassified as a homicide. While the authorities have withheld specific details, they claim that an incarcerated suspect told them he was present when Chris was murdered and thrown off a bridge into the river. Even though police believe this man's story to be credible, no charges have ever been filed. However, one possible theory is that Chris Jenkins could have been the victim in the mysterious Smiley Face murders. During this time period, approximately 40 male college students in the United States were victims in a bizarre series of drowning deaths. In some of these cases, unexplained smiley face graffiti was found near the body of water where the victim drowned. This had led some to theorize these deaths are connected and that the victims were drugged before being thrown into a body of water to make their murder look like an accidental drowning. While no smiley face graffiti was ever found in connection to Chris Jenkins' death, investigators cannot overlook its similarities to many other unsolved cases. So that's it for today's Halloween special. Thank you so much for watching, and I really hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to leave a like. Until tomorrow, goodbye.